gentlemen, no doubt, the first ballot Hall of Famer, the king of hardcore, WWE legend, best-selling author, multiple-time champion. He is the only one, Mick Foley.
Yeah, and what is that one Mick Foley doing here tonight on Raw?
And earlier tonight, he had a major announcement to make. I can tell you this, all the great fans here in Alabama are happy to see Mick Foley. I'm sure the fans watching live at home here tonight on Monday Night Raw are as well.
Well, you forgot to mention that he's a best-selling author as well. The only trouble with Foley's books, usually the covers are too far apart. Except that book that I did with it, you know, that great Christmas Chaos. It was a great book.
All right. Now, just what would the holidays be without a cheap Mick Foley book plug?
Oh, boy.
Now, I said I had an important announcement to make, and believe it or not, this book is not it. Now, I'm not saying it's not important. I'm not saying it wouldn't make a really good Christmas gift idea. What I'm here to talk about is the fact that even though I've been known off and on as a Raw guy for the last couple of years, next week I'm going to temporarily make a little jump over to SmackDown.
What? SmackDown?
Wait a second, guys. This isn't just any SmackDown. This is a very special edition of SmackDown, and I think you'll know what I mean after you take a look at this. Now, I might seem like an unlikely candidate to go overseas in support of our troops. After all, I'll never be called a big pro-war guy, and I've still got a couple of cases of John Kerry for President bumper stickers in my garage. Wait, I forgot, this is a red state, right?
Yeah.
Nonetheless, it was with great gratitude, it was a great honor for me to be invited to the Pentagon to serve as a spokesman for the Department of Defense and their America Supports You campaign. Because I know that supporting the troops goes way beyond any kind of political affiliation. And so I look at it as it will be one of the great privileges of my life to travel overseas and entertain the brave men and women who put their lives on the line for us every single day. Because it is our brave men and women who...
I don't even know what this is. Well, Muhammad Hassan, he is scheduled to be here tonight. Well, I know, certainly not now. I would thank God.
کی توی خونه تلویزیون نگاه میکنین وایسا بگو سلام به محمد حسن
I have had enough I've had to listen to these lies and now you're gonna listen to me like it or not I used to be just like you, Mick Foley, and just like all of these people. I used to blindly support these troops, and I used to blindly support this country. Right up until 9/11. After 9/11, I was forced to open my eyes to the truth. And the truth is, it's people like us that are the real victims of this war. And the truth is that none of you people are real patriots. Because if you were, you would not support a war that promotes the unfair treatment of Arab Americans. This is no longer the land of the free. And this is no longer the home of the brave. I am a prisoner in my own country.
Prisoner.
And I feel your patriotism at every airport, on every corner, and especially right now.
All right, okay, listen, I appreciate your passion. And I did listen, and I can see the sense in a couple of things you say, although, by and large, I disagree strongly with almost every word. But isn't it wonderful that you live in a great country like the United States of America, where you are free to express your views no matter how stupid they sound? Now listen, you annoyed me a little bit, but what's got me really down is you've chosen at this time to come out and interrupt my interview time after an 8-month absence. I'm here talking to the people in Huntsville, Alabama.
I knew you'd get that cheap pop in.
Good, I'm glad I interrupted you because I am sick of hearing you express your admiration for these troops. These gutless cowards. These heartless infidels.
Oh, now you're pissing me off. Yeah. You understand one thing, you've got that right. Because throughout our country's history, brave men and women have bled and fought and died to give you the right to shoot your mouth off. My cousin Russ took a bullet at the Battle of the Bulge so you could shoot your mouth off. Sergeant Michael Caine left a leg in Iraq so you could shoot your mouth off. Nathan Hale was hanged so you'd have the right to say that.
How dare you lecture me on morality? You support an evil and unjust war.
I support America. The home of the brave, the land of the free, with one exception, you see, in this great country, you're free to shoot your mouth off everywhere, but one isolated 20-foot by 20-foot ring. Some call it the squared circle, I'll call it Foley Island. And should you care to step inside Foley Island, I assure you, democracy no longer reigns. Your rights no longer apply, save to, no. Should you choose to wander into Foley Island, you have got the right to feel my fist in your mouth. And you have got the right to feel this boot in your ass. So if you're feeling gutsy, come on, welcome ashore. Foley Island awaits you. Bring it, welcome. I'll be your guide. I'll beat your ass.
No, I don't think I will, because I will not fight a man that I don't respect.
I don't believe this. They don't respect Mick Foley. How can these two men not respect Mick Foley? Well, you can't blame a man for not fighting someone he doesn't respect.